Hey guys, what's going on? It's Looeelooee here, and welcome to another match review. I've got a really good one for you guys today. I'm going to be taking a look at one of Eric Lee's matches, who is one of the top players in the Virginia or like Maryland region. His rating's about 2400, so really, really strong player. And the great thing about this review is he's actually a modern defensive player, so a long pips chopper. So this will be the first match review I do, doing an analysis of a modern defensive player. But the opponent he's going against is also a very strong player, about 2400. And Eric sent me a message basically saying that in this specific match, the opponent he played, it felt like he was playing at a 2600 level, so there wasn't much he could do. The games were close, but the score ended up being 3-0. So I can definitely go ahead and take a look at the match, see if there's some insight I can give, basically just some tips that I can give overall for the match. So let's go ahead and get started, and I hope you guys enjoy the video. Alright, so as usual, let's go ahead and get started with the match. I'll probably be pretty quiet for the first couple minutes or so unless I see something like blaringly obvious that I can point out. And then kind of as the match goes on, I'll give a little bit more insight. Okay, so right off the bat, first couple points, kind of just some simple mistakes, like you had an opportunity to loop on the forehand, and you just had a timing mistake. There you weren't watching how he returned your serve, so pretty typical serve for defensive player, long, hoping he loops, and then you can set up for the chop. But he actually returned this serve with almost no spin. You treated it as if he chopped you heavy. So it kind of caught you off guard, which is why it popped out. So just make sure the second after you serve, you're looking up. Watch how the contact is made off of his paddle. And first game, it's really, really important. Sometimes you're just going to... You may start a little bit cold. You may make some mistakes first game. But it's always important to basically figure out your opponent's preferences. So you should be figuring out which serves they like the most, which serves they don't like the most, what's their typical returns, how are they serving you, and then basically how are you going to follow up based on the shots that they give you. And something else that I've noticed right away, and this is pretty common when you're playing a defensive player, but he's pivoting a lot on his forehand, and most of the time when he loops, he's not giving the ball a huge amount of spin, he's hitting it pretty flat, going for power. So if you give him just slight variation in your placement, he's going to make unforced errors. He's going to make a lot of unforced errors. But yeah, same thing there, actually. Pretty much exactly the same thing. You served, he pushed, you read it like he pushed heavy, and he actually just floated the ball. You don't even have to chop that ball. I know that you have really good attacks. I'd like to see you step around and rip that ball, or even twiddle, just loop your backhand on that ball, and you probably win the point right away. But yeah, if someone, and he's playing well, he hasn't really missed any attacks. Even when you do connect on your chop, he's powering through it instead of spinning it, which makes it incredibly difficult for you to get into the rally. Like, even there he missed, but he's trying to put the point away quickly. In this type of situation, you want to have a more aggressive mindset when you start the point. So you can still, of course, go back to chopping, it's your game, but basically when you get an opportunity, you want to loop first. That way, he's either going to give you a weaker counter loop than his opening loop, or he's just going to block. If he blocks, of course, you can keep looping. If he counters your loop, that'll actually be an easier ball to go back and start chopping on, just because even though it'll be quick, it won't be as fast, so you'll have time to go back and set up that shot. Yeah, right idea. And it looks like first game maybe just a little bit cold, because that's like three or four just unforced errors where it should have been your point, which happens, but you just basically have to keep in mind for the next game, what did you do to set up that opportunity? So there you had a high ball, what did you do to set that up? It was the backhand serve, the first one you've done all match. When you chopped, you actually chopped shorter to the middle there. He stepped in to pop it up, and that gave you the opportunity to attack. So next game, next chance you get, you should have that shot in mind. The shorter push to the middle, he doesn't loop. He pushes it long and gives you that chance. All right, dude, just a little bit of a jam shot. Other things to keep in mind, your backhand serve gave you your best opportunity of the game so far. I wouldn't have gone back to the forehand after seeing how uncomfortable he was against the backhand. Nice. Smart play, good push, solid block. But again, he's kind of ripping. So I would even consider, and I know it can get a little bit tricky, but I would consider dropping some of his serve short. Drop short just to see how he's returning it. If you drop short and you realize that he's just pushing you long, then you might be able to loop that ball first and get into the points. If he's flipping that, then it's going to be an easier ball to chop than the long push. So the long push is great when, you've played me many times. If you jam me long, I don't really kill the ball. I just spin it up and then we get into the rally. If he's killing the ball when you push long, you have to add some variation. That can be slight placement changes because he's going for so much power. It can be depth changes, how wide you're playing, but there has to be some variation to the push. Alright, so second game now, let's go ahead and see if you make any adjustments here and kind of what happens this game. Much better serve, shorter, and then the push was heavy too. Nothing wrong with that point. But then the serve drifts long again. Yeah, so I haven't seen him spin up a single ball. So those long serves, if you are going to serve long like that, it needs to be so heavy. It needs to be like the heaviest underspin that you can put on the ball. Force him to spin it up. Or basically, if he tries to slap it, he should be missing in the net. But yeah. Pretty much every loop he's playing. Even there, that first loop, you push long to his forehand. I would counter that first ball, and then once he blocks your counter or plays a counter against your counter, that's when I would go ahead and try to play defensively. Because he's just putting you under so much pressure, you need to put him under some pressure as well. Aside from that, something else I've noticed just in the first game and a couple points here, is his angles are very predictable. If you jam him here, he almost always comes cross court. If you push him long wide to the forehand, like where my mouse is, he normally comes cross court here. I've seen him hit down the line like a couple times, but like 80-90% of the time he's playing cross court. And you can use that to your advantage. Very predictable. Right idea. That's positive play. You went for your shot, just didn't connect, but that's positive play. I'd like to see you go back to the backhand serve. You used it once, had the best opportunity of the game, and then for some reason you haven't gone back to it. Nice. Really good. Really good. And that's what I'd like to see more of now. Just a little bit more aggression. That doesn't mean loop every ball. That's not your game, of course. But mix in some more attacks. Make him uncomfortable. But yeah, there's the backhand serve. And both times you've used it, he's been very uncomfortable. Nice. Good. So, he is actually more uncomfortable looping your half long and your short balls than he is your jam push. So, every time you've pushed him extremely deep, he's ripped the ball. There you pushed him long, but it was actually a quote-unquote lower quality push. For him, he was more uncomfortable with this push. So, it's something that, again, you should keep in mind. A little bit half long, and that forced him to spin the ball up. And then you have a chance to get into the rally. Which is where your strength's going to be. If you connect on the first chop and it's high quality, you win the point most of the time because he's winning most of his points just outright on the third ball. Beautiful. Really good. Really good. Nice serve placement. Force the half long loop. Great chop. Great attack. Textbook point there. Great idea. Nothing wrong with that point. Had the opportunity to attack and just a little bit of a miss hit on the last shot. He is putting you under a lot of pressure. The only thing I would point out, it's a little bit of a nitpick, is why would you go back to the forehand serve when you're having so much success with the backhand serve? He's really, really uncomfortable against it. So with serves, it's not, and it's something I used to have a problem with. You can't just say this is a good serve. You have to know your opponent, and that's why the first game is also so important. You should use all of your serves the first game. You have to know which serves they don't like and which serves are setting you up for success. There could be a serve that you think is terrible. Most players flip it, kill you on it, and he's popping it up, or he's uncomfortable. So use that serve against him, and you'll be surprised just how many opportunities you can get. A couple of times he's caught you off guard with just quick serves. That's just watching, but it's hard to react to everything. But if he does go quick serve to the middle like that, I'd almost like to see you try and hit that as well before chopping. Great idea. These types of points, if you're losing like this, I think that you're pretty comfortable in these rallies, and if you get enough of these rallies, you're going to come out on top. So I wouldn't worry about them too much, but I am seeing kind of a lot of, like maybe every 1 out of 3 points, you have a chance to chop. It should be more, at least 75% of the points, you should be getting into this type of rally, where you have a chance to chop. Yeah. Right idea, wrong angle on your forehand loop. So this ball here, he's already set up for the backhand. If you loop to the middle, just drag him slightly, that's probably going to be your best chance to either get a very low quality block from him, or he might just outright miss. If you are going to play basically fast to the backhand, then this shot has to be a spinny shot. It can't be a kill shot. Just because if you kill, there's no way you recover for this. If you spin, you still have the footwork to get to the corner. If you want to kill, then you should be going cross court, wide cross court. Alright, another thing is he's cheating on your serve, the forehand serve. That was a good one, very heavy. And that's the level of spin that you should be adding most of the time. You haven't really served, even with the forehand serve, with much variation. So I'd like to see a couple that are short, short forehand. See how badly he's cheating. Maybe he completely misreads if you just go short forehand once. So it might be something that you want to keep in mind. Nice. Solid play. Nothing wrong with that point. A couple of times you've missed that serve where you've tried to basically attack with the pips, and both times you've missed it out a little bit. Could just be kind of a feeling issue. But make sure you're relaxed. Let the ball bounce. When you're attacking a serve, you have to let it bounce just a little bit. If you rush and take it right off of the bounce, that's when you can make those types of unforced errors. That serve might have even come long. Yeah, it could have actually been long to your forehand, and you might have just been able to outright loop that. Because you were already stepping in and rushing on the return, you missed out. Just make sure you're letting the ball bounce. Know where it's coming before you decide on your shot. You shouldn't have the shot decided until you know where the serve is going. Great idea. So every time he's pushed your serve, it's been no spin. I don't know if he's doing it deliberately or it could honestly be the lower quality is throwing you off a little bit, but the fact that he's pushing your serve no spin is why you're missing a lot of them out. Yeah. A little bit too far back on the last shot, but again, that's kind of a shot that I think you land more times than you miss. But it's just a lot of small stuff. It's very, very small margins. And for those of you else who are watching, At this level, like 2400 level, the margins are so small. The difference between like half long and a little bit worse than half long, the difference between a little bit of underspin and a lot of underspin, it makes such a big difference. And the overall outcome of the match, the way that someone plays, it can make a really big difference. But let's go ahead and watch the third game. I'd like to see you continue to use more of the backhand serves. Also mix in more variation on the push, some more just short forehand, outright short forehand, instead of everything long to the backhand. The fact that he is pivoting, I don't think he's looped. He might have looped like one or two backhands, but he's pivoting on everything, which makes his wide forehand weak, his short forehand especially weak. I haven't seen him flip kill anything, so I would challenge that shot, see if he even has it. That was a better response to his push there. You actually twiddled and looped the backhand, so I actually prefer that to the pip shot just because it puts him under some more pressure. If he counter loops, you can go back and chop. If he blocks, you're able to continue looping. Nice, good serve. Yeah, so if you're going to go with that forehand serve, it has to be so heavy. Force him to spin it up. Don't give him the opportunity to kill the ball. Yeah, a couple more just unforced errors. A little bit loose on the chop, but you got away with it there. But that's going to happen as long as you're ready to keep going. Nice. Really good. No comments there. Beautifully played point. And yeah, good rally. Not sure what happened there. I think you would have won that point if you'd played it out. You looked to be winning that point. Not bad, not bad. Much better recognition on his receive. Solid return, just missed the opportunity on your forehand. But you played the point right. If you lose a point like that, that's the type of point you don't want to overthink too much. Yeah, so just a couple missed serves. 2400 level, it's so punishing if you miss serves. It's just something you can't afford to do because you need to be winning 80-85% of your serves really to be competitive. And if you're missing a couple, it might not seem like a lot, 2 points, but it really does make a huge difference when the margins are this small. Yeah, same thing, rushing. Just rushing on that serve. You need to let it bounce a little bit more. Or just go the other way, go to his backhand, play stable. It's situational, and this is something that it's a little bit tricky to figure out, but basically, if your opponent is serving you short forehand, then going deep to their backhand, they're much less likely to pivot. They're much more likely to be surprised by it. So this is a really important point. If you get a serve that's long to your backhand and you push, then almost every right-handed player will pivot on this ball. It's really predictable. So they're not going to be surprised by it. So then they serve short to your forehand. And you think, well, I just pushed to their backhand and they pivoted. So why would I push there again? Well, it's a completely different angle. So if they serve short to your forehand and you push here, now they're going to be surprised by it because you're going down the line. They're either going to loop their backhand, it'll be a lower quality shot. They're going to be surprised, pivot late, and just spin the ball up. But either way, it's actually a better return, and it's going to set you up for success in the rally. A little bit unlucky. And yeah. Couple of kind of unfortunate things have happened in this game. Like, if you hadn't missed your serve, he didn't get that net, really you could be winning this game, and then who knows if it you take the game, he's nervous, it goes to 5, you have a chance, but now he has a lot of momentum and he's playing confident. Yeah, so again, there, that's a predictable return. He's been stepping on that ball. That's where you want to add some variation, and then you can push there when he serves short forehand. Yeah, unfortunate. Really unfortunate. One of those things that just sometimes happens. Got to shake it off, keep playing. When things aren't going your way, you just have to think about what was working. What are you going to do? How is he going to return it? How are you going to follow up on his return? But the other thing is that you're just playing a little bit too defensively. And I know that the style is defense, and you should be going back and chopping most of the time. But you need to be mixing in the attacks more. I'm sure you've played with most of the 2600 choppers. The best thing about their games is their attacks. And when they're serving, they're actually serving to loop first most of the time. If you watch their serves, until they're put under pressure, they're serving short. They're serving like short forehand. They're serving half long. They're trying to get either weak loops that they can counter loop. They're trying to get long pushes to their forehand that they can just rip. And then by doing that, you give yourself a 3-4 point cushion. And then when they do loop, that's when you go back and chop. Or when they counter loop, you go back and chop. But the first idea, especially against a 2400, first idea can't be to chop. First idea still has to be some form of aggressive play, whether that's hitting with the pips, twiddling, looping your backhand, counter looping on the forehand. There has to be just a little bit more aggression. But yeah, 2400, strong player, is also very good at preventing that, forcing you into a more defensive game. Yeah. Not bad. Looks like he had just a lot of momentum at the end, so the game kind of fell away from you. But yeah, biggest things, couple things. Firstly, I don't know why you didn't use the backhand serve more. Maybe you were uncomfortable with it or uncomfortable with the return he was giving you. But he was so uncomfortable against your backhand serve. And that's the type of thing, especially really high level, you just have to pick up on it right away. You can't think, oh, I won the point, next point, and not even think about why you won the point. Or even if you lost the point, was he uncomfortable at that point? Is that a point that I feel happy losing? Like, do I want to play that type of point again? And when you served backhand, you had so many good opportunities. Second thing, when you were flipping, or like hitting with the pips, some of those serves were actually long, but you were stepping in, so you end up jammed, rushed, and the shot misses out. Just make sure you're letting the ball bounce. You'll be surprised how many of his serves were drifting long to your forehand. You can actually loop them. And then aside from that, kind of just what I mentioned in the analysis, I'd like to see a little bit more aggression. But yeah, overall, not bad. I can tell that, honestly, you play him again, you have a good chance to win. You might have been a little bit cold the first game. I don't know. It's a tournament, so that can happen. Maybe cold or nervous. That type of thing just sometimes happens. But yeah, overall, not bad. And again, this is definitely really high level table tennis. But thank you guys so much for watching. That's going to do it for this analysis. If you have questions, then definitely leave them in the comment section below. And if you're new to the channel, please join the Discord server. That's where you can reach out to me, send videos for analysis. Or just chat with everyone from the channel and the community. So the link for that Discord server will be in the description. It'll also be in the comment section down below. And I'd really appreciate it if you check that out. But yeah, thank you guys so much for watching. I should have more reviews up today. If not today, then maybe tomorrow, just because today's my off day. But again, thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll catch you guys in the next video.